Wusstest du, dass Juden untereinander Gedanken lesen können?
Aber wie würdest du sie erkennen? Sie könnten genauso aussehen wie wir.
Hi. Du weißt, was ich bin. Sag es.
Ein Jude.
Halleluja.
Elsa is a young girl who's Jewish and she's going through this really... It's set during World War II, so she's going through a really kind of very scary experience that no one should ever be put through. And in terms of who she is, she's of course a victim, but she's also got so many layers. She's really strong and funny and witty and smart and full of love.
Oh je, das war heftig.
Was mache ich denn jetzt?
Keine Ahnung.
Ich hab's. Ich werde
verhandeln. Wir brennen das Haus nieder und beschuldigen Winston Churchill. Oder verhandeln.
Wenn ich dich verrate, hast du ein Riesenproblem.
Sie werden nie gewinnen. Liebe ist das Stärkste auf der Welt.
Deine Mutter hat mich aufgenommen. Sie ist freundlich. Sie behandelt mich wie einen Menschen.
I think I started with a script, and it's a kind of script where immediately you can't put it down, I guess. It's like I was like, it was glued to my hands, because it's so unexpected in the way that it tells such a well-known story. It takes a really kind of unique take on things. I guess started with the script, and then once I knew I had the role, immediately kind of went into learning as much about what it was like to live in 1944 during World War II as possible. And once I arrived in Prague, where we filmed, going to different sites like Theresienstadt, which was a concentration camp just outside of Prague, and going to the Jewish quarter in Prague and walking around there with a historian who was able to kind of fill in a lot of gaps for me in terms of, yeah, like what it was like living back then. And I went to different synagogues, and I watched, when I first met Taika, when I first sat down with him, I told him all of the research I'd done, and straight away he was like, nah, scrap that. Watch Mean Girls and The Heathers. And I was like, okay, interesting approach. But then I kind of, once I did, and once I talked to Taika about it a bit more, I realized it was, the aim was kind of to focus more on, like I said before, more on the fact that she isn't defined by you know, World War II, or by being a victim. She's also, you know, lived a life before this disgusting war. She's, you know, she's a teenager, she's a young woman who could have been in the popular group at school, she could have been anything, and we don't have the privilege of knowing what her life was before World War II. But we do know, when we meet her, we do know that she's very complex. And
ihr scheint euch ja gut zu vertragen.
Sie scheint kein schlechter Mensch zu sein.
Ich bin der Feind. Du bist kein Nazi, Jojo. Du bist ein 10-jähriger Junge, der gerne in lustigen Uniformen herumläuft und zu einem Verein dazugehören will.
Well, I'm from an kind of a family that's been in the film industry for a while, and in my family I'm a third generation actress. So it's something that I've always been around, and I've always been able to watch my grandma and my mum and my dad work and act and write and direct. So I've constantly been learning and absorbing things through osmosis. I didn't want to do it at first, but when I was 13, I did a role in a film called Consent, which was a true story about a lady called Louise Nicholas, a New Zealander called Louise Nicholas, and she was raped by policemen when she was 13, and that abuse continued into her young adult life, and it turned into a group of policemen taking advantage of her. And I came out of that experience realizing that it's such an important film, is and entertainment is such an important medium. I think during the war, people used comics and film and reading as a way to distract themselves from the horrors that were happening all around them. And it's just a kind of a channel to to, I don't know, be a part of the conversations and be a part of, I don't know, the wider community, I guess. Yeah, it's just a way to tell important stories and express myself.